Alright, and welcome back to the final model in the Titans building block series for the mill. And this one's going to put everything you got to the test. So, without further ado, let's get going. So here's sheet one. It is pretty straightforward, a rectangle with the ends cut off into a taper and a thickness of 0.876, which is different this time. Everything else has been 0.75 leading up to this one. Alright, we'll fast forward through all the file saving, component creating, and the sketch creating, and start at that point. Alright, so now we're going to begin with creating our sketch. We'll save that sketch and rename it. Sheet 1, basic shape, or something like that. Now we're going to start off by creating a simple rectangle, starting from the origin, drag it out, and dimension it 1.9 and 8. Enter. Now we'll create the tapered ends. That's fairly straightforward on that one. We'll select line, or L, and we'll create four lines roughly in kind of the same look as the print. We'll dimension them right away and make it perfect. So with that, we'll get the dimension tool out, so D for dimension, or click up there. We're going to click on the origin and our first point. We're going to type in 1, enter, origin, second point, 7, enter, and we'll go the other way, origin, first point, 0.375, enter, and origin, point 1.525, enter. Now we can use our horizontal and vertical constraint to line up everything else. So we'll click there, we'll click there, now it's black and constrained. We'll click there, and we'll click there, black and constrained. And finally there, and there, black and constrained. And there, and it's already figured that one out because it automatically did, but you may have to click there as well. We'll finish the sketch, we'll extrude it. So click on extrude, click on the part we want, type in negative 0.876. This is the only part that isn't the same negative 0.75 dimension. So we'll click on fillet. We'll click on the four edges that we want to fillet. And we'll type in 1, enter, for a 1 inch radius. And that's it. So here we have sheet 2. The only thing we're doing on this sheet is we're going to be creating three pins that stick out the bottom of the part. And we'll take care of that with a simple sketch and extrusion. So let's do that. Alright, so to create the pins, we're going to need to create a new sketch on the bottom of the part. So we'll roll the part over so we can see the bottom. And now we can also click on the bottom in the view cube to do the same. We'll create a new sketch, click the bottom of the part, and then we'll rename that sketch sheet2/pins. Now we're going to need to create the three pins. They're just circles, so click on circle. Let's just draw three circles, and then we'll fix it with the dimensions. So we're going to click equals, and we're going to make sure that all three equal each other. That way we can dimension the first one, and the rest will be the same. So we'll hit D for dimension, we'll click on our circle, and we'll type in 0.275, enter. And now they're all the same. Now we'll grab our dimension tool, and we'll dimension from the origin to the first point, and we'll enter 0.950, and then we'll dimension from the other direction 2.152, enter. This point to this point, We're going to type in 4, enter, and this point to this point is 5.848. Enter. Now all we got to do is just do a horizontal constraint and make them all horizontal with each other. And that's it. Looking good. So we can finish the sketch and we can move on to the extrusion process. So you may be wondering, how much do I extrude this part by? Well, we have a pin depth of 0.876, and then we need to extrude that away until it is 0.676. So all we're going to do is do the math inside Fusion. So we'll click drag up, then we'll have a look inside the extrude box. So we're going to need to do a little math inside our distance box. So we'll start with typing in negative bracket 0.876 minus 0.676, close bracket, enter. And that will do the math for us. And there we go. We can verify we did the math right by using inspect, measure, and measuring between the two faces. And we should have a dimension of 0.676. There we go. Sheet 2 is done. So we have a lot to do on this sheet. And I know that there's a lot of dimensions and it makes it look really, really confusing and difficult. But we're going to break it down into individual chunks. So we'll do each chunk at a time and we'll end up with a finished product that looks just like this. So let's begin. Alright, so to start the honeycomb knockout section there, we're going to need to create a new sketch on the top plane, or top surface, and rename it. Call it Sheet 3 Honeycomb. What we want to do is, you'll notice the honeycomb patterns are all within a large rectangle. So we'll create that first. So we'll create a three circles first, and these circles are going to be the center hub of the honeycomb pattern. So first we'll dimension it. So our first hole is going to be 0.375, and then we'll make them all equal to one another with the equal constraint, and then we can use the concentric constraint to drop them right in place using the pin geometry from sheet 2. After which we can turn sheet 2 off. We don't need that anymore if you wish. So next we need to create the rectangles. We're going to need two of them. So we'll start with a center point rectangle and we'll snap to the center of the center pin and we'll just drag it out. We'll dimension it afterwards. So D for dimension. We click on origin, first corner, and type in 1.1, enter. We'll dimension the other side of the rectangle, 0.15, enter. So there's our first rectangle. Our second one, we'll do the same thing, center point rectangle. We'll snap to the center of the other rectangle. We'll drag it out till it touches and snaps to the first rectangle, click it, and then we'll dimension it. D for dimension, top and bottom, and we'll give it a dimension of 0.1. Enter. And finish the sketch. Now we can extrude and cut that chunk out. So click each side. And we'll just roll the part over, click the bottom, and that'll tell it how far to extrude. It'll cut, and it's gone. And that lets us now create the honeycomb pattern inside there. So let's move on to the next. All right, so next step, we need to create another sketch. So we'll click on Create Sketch, click on the top of our part, and then we can rename our sketch Sheet 3, and give it another name, just so we can differentiate. We'll call this webs, because we're going to use the web command on this. So what we're going to do is we're going to turn on our first sheet, or sorry, our knockout sheet, and then we'll go to polygon, and we're going to click on circumscribe polygon. We're going to click on and snap to the center of that hub that we made before, and we're just going to drag it out until we snap to the edge of the rectangle. Alright, make sure you're getting that triangle, or well, that snap symbol. So now we can turn off the knockout sheet, and let's just click on these lines right here. We don't need them, so we're going to get rid of them, make life easier. So just click on them, then hit delete on the keyboard, and it should look like this. So now what we need to do is create what are called webs. So we'll finish our sketch, and we're going to go up to the create menu, and we're going to go to web, and we're going to click on those lines, and you can see that it creates that solid on either side. So we'll keep clicking, we'll click them all, and then we'll enter in our dimension. So we're going to enter in 0.08, and that's looking pretty good, but the problem is it sticks out the bottom. And this is a glitch. You have to just come up here, change this to next, and then immediately change it back to depth. And then it'll let you enter a depth. Again, this is a glitch in the software, but this is the fix. 0. And then the thickness of our part is 676. And hit enter. And there we go. We have some of our webbing done. Looks nice. Very good. Hit home. And then we'll move on to the next step. So we need to create the other half of the webs that go in the other direction. So guess what? It's another sketch. We love our sketches. So we'll create a new sketch on the top of the part. We'll rename it sheet 3/webs2 or something like that, just to keep it interesting. And then what we need to do is turn on the previous sheet for webs, because we're going to need some of that geometry. Line command, and we're just going to draw a line across. But we can't snap to these points because Fusion's weird that way. So what we're going to do is we are going to just draw a line across. Doesn't really matter, just like that. Boom, boom. All right. And sometimes you get these little tail things because it registers double clicks. Don't worry about that. We'll just delete them. So just X is very good. Let's hit escape. We'll go back and we'll delete these little tail things, like I said. It's just the computer's registering extra clicks and creating extra lines. So once we got those deleted, we'll grab the coincident constraint, and we're just going to make these points coincident with the points from the previous sheet, because coincident will let us snap to there. So use your constraints. Make them all perfect. Get them all constrained so that they're black and in place, because we're going to turn these into webs as well, as I'm sure you probably already guessed. All right, looking good. Two more, and then we can move on to our web command. So finish sketch, looks good. Turn off the previous sketch, we don't need that anymore. Go up to create and web. We'll select our curves, all those lines, looking good. Might have to rotate it there to grab them. So we'll pick all of them. Should be 6 of them. All right, let's have a look at the input box, 0.08 for our thickness, and then just like before, we're gonna have to change the depth to next, and then back again, just to get past that glitch, and then type in 0.676, and then hit OK. And there we go. We have all the webbing done. Just have to do some fillets, and it'll look the same as the sheet. So let's do our fillets now and finish up this honeycomb pattern. So you guessed it. Time to select all the edges and fillet them. So hit fillet, and then we're going to use selection priority to get what we need. So select edge priority, make sure it's checkmarked, go back, just double check. Is there a check mark there? Yes, there is. Excellent. And then, as always, we drag a box right to left in order to window select all those points. So, position it, window select through it, and then looks good. All right, so type in 0.127, enter, and there they are. Got that honeycomb look. Everyone loves honeycombs. Time for the cutouts, and you know what time that is. It is time for another sketch. We'll place that sketch on top of the part, and we'll rename that sheet 3 and give it something else just to kind of give it an idea of what it is. So pockets or cutout, whatever works for you. All right, so pretty quickly, we'll make this happen fast. So we're going to use line tool, and we're just going to create a pattern, a profile that looks like that. All right, now we can use our constraints. We'll use parallel constraint to make sure that is parallel with the edge of the part, and that line is parallel with the edge of that part, and that is parallel with the front. Get a triangle now with dimension. So click the edge, we'll click the line, and we'll give it a dimension of 0.14. Do the same thing on the other side. Line, edge, 0.14. Enter. And then we need to dimension that to there, and 0.1 for that. Now we've got this triangle. Let's just run a line down the center here. Make sure it's perpendicular, and enter. Now what we can do is we can create a rectangle, center point, rectangle, and just find the midpoint of that line, which is that triangle snap, drag it out, place it, and then we'll dimension it as 0.1. Enter. And done. So now we can finish the sketch, and we can do the extrusion. We'll hit extrude. We'll click on the two pieces, and then we'll extrude it, negative 0.5. Enter. Done. Looking good. Now for some fillets. Fillet command. One, two, three, four edges, and it gets filleted. 0.15. Enter. Next, we'll fillet the front edges here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Type it in. 0.015. Enter. Now, we didn't draw the other side because we're going to do a mirror here. First of all, we need a construction plane to mirror across. We're going to do construct, and we're going to select the drop-down menu. We're going to find midplane. We're going to click on the end of each end of the part, so that end, rotate it around, we'll click that end, we get a nice midplane here, hit OK. We'll go to the create menu, we'll go down to mirror, it asks us to select our objects, we're going to select them in the timeline, we're going to select the extrusion and the two fillets, select mirror plane, click on the midplane, and boom. Hit OK. We have the cutouts or pockets done, and turn off the construction plane. All right, so now we're going to make the counterboard holes on each end, and that's going to require a sketch. So let's set our sketch to the bottom of that pocket this time, and what we're going to do is put some points down and then use the hole command. So we'll create point, drop 4 points down, and then we'll dimension them out. So D for dimension, or click dimension, and we'll start with the origin to the first point, drag it up, and we're going to type in 0.745. Enter. We'll click the origin and at the same point, bring it out the other way, 0.558, enter. And now we've got that one centered. We can use our vertical and horizontal constraints, place those in line. We'll dimension the next one over there, drag it up, and we're going to give it a dimension of 7.255, enter. Okay, and then we'll dimension this last one here, there and there, drag it out, and give it a dimension of 1.342, enter. Again, back to the horizontal vertical constraints and bring those into place. And there we go. We'll finish the sketch. And now we can create the holes using the hole command. And same as all the other holes, click them, click the points. Don't worry about how it looks because we're going to fix that. Let's have a look at the hole options box. So we're going to click on counter bore, and looks good. So the next step will be to make sure that hole type is just simple. Drill point is fine. We're going to be cutting through the entire part, so we'll go distance is all. Looks good. All right. Let's set our diameter of our counter bore to be 0.380. And our depth of counter bore needs to be 0.80. Last thing we need to do is set the diameter of the through hole, which in the case of this part is going to be 0.26, and we can hit OK or enter. And there's our holes. Now, we could have drawn these holes in the previous operation and mirrored it with the rest, but in keeping things simplistic, we're going to do it this way. Rename it sheet 3 / counterbores or something that helps you out there. All right, save your work because we don't want to lose it, and we'll move on to the next step. All right, we have a few holes to create on the top of the part, so we're going to use existing geometry from the webs. So we'll turn them on, we'll click hole, and we'll pick the points that correspond to our print. Those three there, one in the middle, and the other three on the other side. May need to zoom in to pick them. All right, let's head over to the dialog box now and enter in our settings. We want it to be a simple hole, but it is tapped, so make sure tapped is selected. Thread offset, and we're going to use a drill point. So distance will be all. All right, so the thread starts from the top at 0. We're going to set a depth of 0.5 for the thread, and then regular drill points fine, and then select our proper thread. So it's number 10, 30 seconds, 2B, and modeled. That looks good, hit OK. All right. Let's turn off these sketches so we can see. There we go. There's our nice 7 threaded holes. Very, very nice. Okay. So let's move on to the next one. All right. So now we're going to create the final shape of the part where it's sort of tapered from thick to thin at the front. So we're going to create a sketch on the front of the part. We'll call it sheet 3, and we'll name it something. Let's try a taper cuts, taper profile, something like that. We're going to take a line, and we're just going to draw a line through the part like that. We're also going to draw two more lines, kind of look like that, and kind of look like this. And then we'll use dimensions to sort them out and some constraints. So let's start by using coincidence, and we're going to make the end of this line coincident with the upper right corner of the part, like that. We're going to make this point coincident with the edge of the part. Then we'll dimension it. So origin to from that line is going to be, there we go. Now it's black and constrained. So let's deal with the other two lines. So we're going to coincidence. We're going to make that point coincident with the front of the part. And we're going to make that point coincident with the line we just drew. And at this end, we will make that point coincident with the front and this point coincident with the line. Same thing again. Now we'll dimension, so origin to that point is going to be 6.819, enter. And origin to this point is going to be 0.4, enter. All right, let's do this end now, click there. All right, 1.181, enter. And this one to there is going to be 0.425, enter. All right, they're all black and they're constrained. The only thing we need to do now is make them into a profile. They're not actually a profile. As you can see, when we put our mouse over them, they don't turn blue. So let's take the line tool. Let's just quickly draw three lines, boom, to there, boom, over there, boom, and down there, boom. Let's grab horizontal vertical constraints and fix that. Just make them perfect. There we go. One more. Beautiful. Now we can, now those are profiles that we can extrude. So speaking of extrude, let's finish the sketch and let's extrude those. So we'll go up to the create menu, extrude. Let's click on all those profiles. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we'll just click the other side of the part for the distance and done. Hit OK. Now we just have a filleting job to do and that portion of the part is done. So let's go up to fillet in the modify menu. We're going to come down and zoom in on our part, and we'll pick the parts that need to be filleted right there at the cut. 1, 2, and 3, and 1, 2, and 3 at that end. Looks good. All right, and let's enter our fillet radius of 0.6, enter. All right, that looks splendid. All right, so to finish up the Titan 10M, we need to do our chamfers and break all these hard edges. Now the problem is that at the time of recording this video, the select priority was just not working properly. So the only option that we have is to individually select each area to be chamfered. So here I have started the chamfer tool and I'm just going through and picking each and every edge. And this is going to be a long and painful process. Believe me, I tried hard to get the selection priority to work, but for some reason, it just, no matter what I did, it wouldn't work. So if you can get it to work, cool. But otherwise, you're just going to have to select every individual edge and chamfer it. So the first few we'll do together. 0.01 is our standard chamfer distance, and there we go. We've got the dialog box here. Just press plus to create a new selection set and then go ahead and select more. So do it in stages, because if you make a mistake and hit escape or something by accident, you lose all those edges you selected. So I do it, you know, a few at a time. And then so here we go, here's another group, 0.01. Then I'll hit plus, create a new selection set, and I'll keep going. So there isn't a whole lot more to say. It's just a long and painful process. But you're on the home stretch now, and this is a pretty complex part, and you should be proud of yourself for getting to this point in the all the tutorials as well as this part itself. So we'll just keep going. And I'll see you at the end. All right, so that's it. You're done. Congratulations. You've done all 10 of the Titanium building block tutorials. And congratulations. Thanks for following along, and I hope you've learned a lot.